Around 300 million years ago, there was an Earth with all the continents and land united. The largest supercontinent the Earth has ever known, called Pangea, meaning Pan, all, and Gea, the Earth, in Greek. Pangea, which makes up almost one-third of the Earth's surface and is encircled by the enormous ocean Pan Thalassa at the time, was created by smaller landmasses such as Gondwana, Euramerica, Laurasia, and many more over the course of millions of years during the Carboniferous. But sadly, nothing lasts forever, and the massive landmass that covered Earth's surface slowly broke apart. Pangea progressively fractured at the beginning of the Mesozoic era, from 250 to 150 million years ago at the start of the Jurassic.
As a result, the climate underwent significant shifts and experienced extinction events. Hot magma in the Earth's mantle is constantly moving in a convection current, which causes the plate above it to move. Over the course of millions of years, this causes the continents to drift away or collide with one another, which is what caused Pangea to break apart. The Himalayas, the Pacific Ring of Fire, the Mariana Trench, and many other prominent characteristics of Earth's surface were also caused by these events, and plate tectonics will continue to shift and change the planet's surface.
Along with the breakup of Pangea, there were two main extinction events that occurred during the early Jurassic: the end-Triassic mass extinction, ETME, and Torsion Oceanic Anoxic Event, TOAE, also known as the Jenkins Event.
The ETME marks the boundary between the Triassic and Jurassic periods, approximately 201.4 million years ago. Although the cause of the ETME is not entirely clear, it has been suggested that large-scale volcanic eruptions that occurred in a short time period caused the event. These eruptions, which were located at the Central Atlantic Magmatic Province, also known as CAMP, spewed forth large amounts of lava and gas, predominantly carbon dioxide, sulfur, and methane. Due to this, intense global warming and ocean acidification ensued. It has also been linked to forest fires on land and anoxia at sea. This resulted in the extinction of 76% of marine and terrestrial species, paving the way for the dinosaurs.
Recent studies have shown that the ETME occurred in two phases, which happened several thousand years apart. Previously, it was believed that it happened at once. During both phases, many species of bivalves and ostracods went extinct. Additionally, conodonts suffered during the first phase, but were completely wiped out in the second.
The Torsion Oceanic Anoxic Event occurred 183 million years ago and was a hypothermal event similar to the ETME, but it was less intense. It was thought to be caused by the eruption of the Karoo-Fera Large Igneous Province, two igneous provinces in modern-day South Africa and Antarctica, respectively. It was associated with elevated temperatures, a carbonate production crisis, and higher rates of primary productivity. The TOAE is believed to be possibly the most extreme case of widespread oxygen deoxygenation in the entire Phanerozoic eon. Extinction rates were high in terrestrial and marine environments. The two main causes of the end Cretaceous mass extinction, also known as the KPB event, are still uncertain, but it is thought to have been caused by a combination of factors, such as an asteroid impact, volcanic eruptions, and climate change. Deccan volcanism caused short-term global cooling, long-term climate warming, and a biotic crisis. According to a new Mercury analysis, major Deccan eruptions have accelerated over the last 10,000 years of the Cretaceous and have reached the tipping point, resulting in mass extinction. The asteroid impact caused global cooling and a food crisis in fauna. The long-term negative effects of Deccan volcanism and asteroid impact on floral and faunal life point to LIP volcanism, toxicity, and ocean acidification as a major cause for mass extinction. Some studies support that the main cause was an asteroid impact, while others argue that it was LIP volcanism.
Over the last few years, many studies have provided new information on the topic. During the early Jurassic, there was a significant increase in atmospheric concentrations of greenhouse gases from the seafloor. Plant scale model data suggests a tripling of carbon dioxide. This increase, however, was not consistent due to several smaller carbon cycle fluctuations within the Cinnamurian and Pliens-Bacian transition, which occurred approximately 190.8 million years ago. These fluctuations resulted in the reorganization of oceanic currents as well as the creation of the Hispanic Corridor, connecting the Tethys Ocean to the East Pacific.
The magnitude of warming due to increased greenhouse gas concentrations has been estimated via oxygen isotopic analysis of belemnites, suggesting temperature changes of 5 to 8 degrees Celsius. the net increase in temperature caused an acceleration of the hydrological cycle in the early Jurassic. This increased continental weathering and runoff, thereby increasing riverine fluxes and oceanic productivity.
The late Cretaceous climate was generally known as hot and humid. The sea surface temperature ranged from 27 to 37 degrees Celsius. The late Cretaceous period experienced five LIP events. The occurrence of LIP volcanic activity on the ocean floor has been associated with oceanic anoxic events, also called OAE. As shown in the image, OAE2 corresponds to the late Cretaceous maximum global temperatures from 90 million years ago. The onset of OAE2 has been widely linked to temperatures caused by LIP volcanic activity.
The greenhouse effect caused by high levels of CO2 in the atmosphere was one of the causes of the high temperature. The end of Cretaceous temperature decrease was caused by decreasing CO2 levels. The late Cretaceous period witnessed the highest sea level in the Phanerozoic. The maximum sea level reached 240 to 250 meters above today's mean sea level. The high sea level, sea spreading rate, and greenhouse gases have caused the opening of deep water connections and deep water circulations in the Atlantic Ocean. These effects are also associated with the continued breakup of Pangea. Australia separated from Antarctica 85 million years ago, and the southern hemisphere continents gradually separated from each other as the Cretaceous period progressed.
Pangea broke apart over a period of tens of millions of years. Its breakup led to several mass extinctions such as the ETME, the TOAE, and possibly the KPG, through the formation of large igneous provinces. During the early Jurassic, Pangea was in the early stages of breaking up, while the modern-day continents were almost completely separated by the late Cretaceous. While we may know a lot about these time periods and discoveries are still being made today, it would be impossible to learn everything about them because they lasted tens of millions of years.
If you found this video interesting and wanted to find out more about different periods of Earth's history, don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell for more content. Thanks for watching.